Good morning, students. This is Shivani Kumari here, your teacher of English, and I will teach you English literature in this video. So, in the previous video, we have completed the chapter 3, Appu and the Carrot. No, I think this is the chapter, chapter 3, Appu and the Carrot. We have also completed some exercises of that chapter. Now, I will complete some other exercises of that chapter, okay? So, we have completed till the F number. Now, I will start the number G. Okay. So, just below the F number, we have fill in the missing letters to name these vegetables. Okay. Chapter 3, Appu and the Carrot. Appu and the Carrot. Okay. So, this is the chapter name. Now, we have fill in the missing letters to name these vegetables. So, here we have total 3 name of our vegetables with some blanks. Now we have to complete these blanks. Number 1 is, in the number 1 we have P, U, M, P, K, dash, M. This is the first one. Number 2, C, dash. Number 3rd, C dash P S I dash U M. Number 3. So the first one is pumpkin, and we guys already know the meaning of, sorry, the spelling of a pumpkin, P U M P K I N. Pumpkin. Pumpkin means kaddu. Okay, number 2, carrot, C-A-R-R-O-T. So, in the second we have carrot. Carrot means gajar. C, number 3rd, we have capsicum. Capsicum. P-S-C-M. Okay, capsicum. Capsicum means Simla Mirch. So, we have total 3 vegetables name in this exercise. Now I will do the question number G, which is no grammar section. Question number G. It's a no grammar section, and it means in this section we have to know about something grammar, okay? So, read the sentences, because in the previous chapter we got to know about the pronoun, okay, as I know already know, okay. Read the sentences up, and in this grammar section, we guys have to know about some prepositions or helping verbs. Appu is in the park, and Appu and Grandma are in the park. So, we have, here we have is in blue color and are in blue color. So, as we guys already know that, is and are helping verb. ये क्या है? ये सब helping verb है. ये main verb को help करते हैं sentence form करने में. So Appu is in the park. Appu park में अगर हम direct लिखते हैं Appu in the park, so it's not a correct sentence. That's why we need a helping verb to complete the sentence to get the proper meaning of the sentence. Appu is in the park. So is helping Appu here to form a sentence, and Appu and Grandma are in the park. So, are is helping Appu and Grandma to form a sentence. So, Appu is a main verb and Appu and Grandma is a main verb. So, we are in this question number G, we have fill in the blanks with is or are. Fill in the blanks with is or are. Now this is our heading is or are. Here we have total 5 fill in the blanks and we just have to use the is or are to complete the sentence. So first of all we have to know where can we use is and where we can use the are. What is the difference between is or are? So first of all let me tell you what is the difference between is or are. So is or are. So we use is for one person or a thing. Whenever we talk about something is in a single form or in a singular number, we always use is. Okay, whenever we talk about more than one person or a thing, we always use are to show them. Okay, जब भी हम किसी भी एक person के बारे में बात कर रहे होते हैं या एक चीज़ के बारे में बात कर रहे होते हैं, हम वहाँ पे is का use करते हैं. But हमें ये भी notice रखना होता है कि हम जिस चीज़ के भी बारे में बात कर रहे हैं वो present form में होना चाहिए. Okay, क्योंकि is और are का form use होता है present form में, ना कि past वाले form में. तो इज वहाँ लगता है जहाँ पे हम किसी भी एक चीज़ एक पर्सन के बारे में बात कर रहे हैं, मतलब सिंगुलैरिटी को जहाँ शो करता है वहाँ पे हम इज लगाते हैं. जहाँ पे प्लूरल नंबर शो हो जाता है वहाँ पे आर को यूज़ करते हैं. जब भी हम बात करेंगे मोर देन वन पर्सन और थिंग वी विल यूज़ आर. एंड वेन एवर वी टॉक अबाउट ओनली वन पर्सन और थिंग वी विल यूज़ इज. ओके, सो दिस इज़ द सिंपल बेसिक रूल ऑफ यूजिंग इज और आर. Now we have the first sentence. Appu and the pom pom. Appu and pom pom dash in the room. Dash in the room. Number 2, the fruits are the fruit dash in the bowl, in the bowl. Okay, not bowl, this is bowl, b-o-w-l, bowl. Yeah, we can also say bowl, but bowl is the proper way. Number 3, a jug dash on the table. Number 4, the pillows dash on the bed. Number 5, there is dash a toy on the rug. So what we have to focus to get how, where can we use is or are, we have to focus on the subject of the sentence. Okay, Appu and the pom pom dash in the room. So what is subject in this first sentence? Appu and the pom pom. So here we have two person. So whenever we talk about for more than one person, so we will use are. So Appu and the pom pom are in the room. Okay, then we have second, the fruits. The fruits. So as you can notice that ki yahan pe fruit ke sath s laga. So whenever we turn something into a plural form, we always use s. Okay, s is also is a letter we use to convert any word into a plural form. Okay, hum s ka use karte hain kabhi kabhi words ko plural form mein badalne ke liye. To ye plural form mein ho gaya, yani yahan pe jo fruits hai wo more than one hai. To the fruits are in the bowl. Yahan pe kya ho jayega, fruits are, kyunki ek se zyada phal hai, to fruits are in the bowl. Number 3, a jug dash on the table. As you guys can notice that a jug, it means ek jug hai. So whenever we talk about or whenever we notice one thing in a sentence, we use is. So a jug is on the table. The pillows, so as you guys already noticed that we have s in the pillow, it means we